Your RODI system is your reef defender. It prevents harmful contaminants from ever entering your aquarium water. This is why it's so important to properly maintain your RODI system. The biggest challenge that most hobbyists face is knowing precisely when to change out their filter cartridges. But you're in luck, because today we're going to show you how to properly monitor your filter cartridges and get the most out of your RODI system. The recommendation you often hear in the hobby is to change your sediment, carbon, and DI cartridges every 6 to 8 months and your TFC membrane every 2 years. While this is a good starting point, it can be misleading. The rate at which cartridges are exhausted actually depends on the level of impurities in your tap water and how much water you're producing using your RODI system. If your tap water is clean or you do not use that much DI water, you may be prematurely changing out your filter cartridges and therefore wasting money. On the other hand, if the quality of your tap water is poor or you use a substantial amount of DI water, you may be inadvertently allowing harmful impurities into your aquarium. The most important tool is a TDS meter, which measures the total dissolved solids in parts per million, or PPM for short. The HM digital inline TDS meters are among the most popular because they allow you to take readings while your RODI system is operating. Water exiting the DI should read 0 or 1 PPM. When the TDS reading begins to rise, it means that the DI is exhausted and should be replaced. We recommend changing your DI cartridge when your TDS reading is 3 to 5 PPM. If your tap water has unusually high amounts of sediment, you may need to change out your sediment filter more often. It is easy to tell when your sediment cartridge is clogged because it will turn color from white to a medium brown. You'll also see a drop in water pressure inside the membrane housing. Low water pressure will slow down water production and make the TFC membrane less efficient. You should replace the sediment filter cartridge when water pressure drops by 15 to 20%. Most aquarium hobbyists change the carbon block filter at the same time as the DI. The carbon filter's main job is to remove chlorine and chloramine. If you live in a municipality that uses chloramine, it's a good idea to monitor your carbon cartridge weekly. An exhausted carbon filter may allow chlorine or chloramine through your system, which can damage the TFC membrane and exhaust your DI cartridge prematurely. To test your carbon filter, you will need a total chlorine or a free chlorine test kit. Allow your RODI system to run for 10 minutes, then test the wastewater coming from the RODI system for the presence of chlorine. If the chlorine measures above 0.5 ppm, it is time to change out the carbon filter. The TFC membrane is the heart of your RODI system. This is because it removes 95 to 98% of the impurities from the water that's passing through it. When properly cared for, a TFC membrane can last anywhere from 1 to 3 years. However, they are quite sensitive and can be easily damaged. Accidentally running hot water through the system, allowing it to freeze, or allowing the membrane to dry out are the most common reasons that will cause a TFC membrane to prematurely fail. In order to test your membrane, you will need to measure the TDS of both the tap water entering your system and the product water coming out of the membrane before it travels through the DI filter. Having a triple inline TDS meter is helpful here because you can install one of the inline probes between your membrane and the DI cartridge. After passing through the membrane, your water should have no less than 95% of the impurities removed. For example, if your tap water TDS is 100 ppm, then the TDS reading after the membrane should be about 5 ppm or less. Once your TFC membrane allows more than 5% of impurities to pass through it, it's time for a new one. Flushing your TFC membrane regularly with a flush valve kit is important because it will extend the life of your membrane and ensure optimal performance. If your RODI system doesn't have a flush valve kit on it, be sure that you pick one up because the manual flush valve kits are really inexpensive and can double the life of your TFC membrane. Be sure to turn off the supply water line before replacing RODI filter cartridges. Spilling a small amount of water is inevitable since there isn't any way to magically drain all of the water out of an RODI system after it's been used. So keep a towel or small bucket handy. Gently remove the filter housing with an RO wrench or plumber's pliers to access and change your filter cartridges and/or membrane. When reinstalling the canisters, be sure to hand tighten only. Over-tightening the canisters may cause leaks or damage. Knowing how to properly monitor your RODI filter system will save you time and money because you'll know precisely when to change out your filter cartridges. More importantly, you'll be protecting your reef from being poisoned by harmful contaminants. If you have questions about how to monitor your RODI filter system or wish to purchase any of the products discussed in the video today, please feel free to contact our aquarium experts for fast and friendly service. Thank you for tuning in, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.